Student, I'm Rose. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is Standard 5, Science. Chapter 5, that is Food, Health and Hygiene. So we are going to learn about the food, health and hygiene. That means what kind of food we should eat, how should we keep our body healthy, and how we should prevent our body from various diseases. Okay, so this is the topic that we are going to study in this chapter. So before going through this chapter, before we discuss about this chapter, we'll just go through the important points that we are going to learn in this chapter. That is the food and health, other factors of affecting our health, disease and the hygiene. So these are the most important topic that we are going to cover in this chapter. Okay, so if you talk about the question, if you arises that why do we need food or why do we eat food, yes or no? So the answer, or we can say, first of all, you just say that we eat food when because of we are hungry, yes or no? We just casually we answer it, we need food for because we are hungry. But actually we need the food for getting energy, yes or no? We get energy from the food, and we do with that energy we do various activity. Yes, we do various activities. Yes, so all the animals and plants, all the living beings need food and for the healthy body. Yes or no? So because of that, the people eat the food and they do various works. Okay, so you can see the food we eat is called the diet. Yes or no? The food which we eat daily, the breakfast, the lunch, we eat the snacks, we eat the dinner. Yes or no? All that food which we eat, that is called the diet. Okay, and a food with all the essential nutrients in right proportion is called the balanced diet. Okay, so the what is balanced diet? That is food with all the essential nutrients. That means what are the essential nutrients? If you talk about, there are various nutrients that we get from the various food. Yes or no? Various food which we eat. Yes or no? So what are the various nutrients that we get? That is the carbohydrates, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals, water and roughage. Okay, so these are the important nutrients that we get from the food that we eat. Yes or no? So everybody doesn't eat any food that we can say, for example, if you say everybody need a different food or different diet. Yes or no? For example, a children need more protein, or we can say they need more food for the development and growth of the plant. Growth of the body. Yes or no? So due to that, they need more carbohydrates, they need more protein, they need more fats, they need more vitamins and minerals, they need more water and roughage. Okay, so for the development of the body, and so that the body can work properly. Okay, so this is what is called the balanced diet. So all these nutrients should be there in a right way. So this balance diet depend on we got three things. One is the whether it is a male or female, whether it is a age group. It depends on age group. It depends on the occupation or the work what they do. Okay. So this balance diet depend on all three things. Okay. So for example, children need various, we can say they need more carbohydrate because they need energy for studying, energy for various activities like we say playing, reading, or we can say dancing. There are so many physical activities, they need more energy, yes or no? Then the protein, if you talk about this, small children need more protein. Why? Because their body growth is more, yes or no? Their body develops so much. Because of that, the protein is also called the bodybuilding food. So it develops the body in physical way, and even it repairs the cells inside your body. Okay, so another is the fats. Fats also one type of a energy giving food. Okay, this is stored we can say in the form of a fats in your body. Okay, another the vitamins and minerals. This is also called the protective food. Okay, and this is very necessary for the immune system. That means development of immunity. Okay, for the fighting against various diseases. Another the water and roughage. This is for the proper digestion, or we can say regulating the temperature, or we can say metabolic process, for regulate the metabolic process in your body. Okay, so that is how the small children needs more and more this all nutrients. Okay, if you talk about detail about this carbohydrates, it is also called the energy giving food. Okay, and mainly we get from this carbohydrate from both plants and animals. We get this both this carbohydrate from both plants and animals that are the source of the carbohydrates. Okay, and it is classified into three. That means it has three type of carbohydrates. That is the sugar, starch, and the cellulose. Okay, so these are this here I have written two important one. That is the sugar and the starch. Okay, so this both starch and the sugar are we get from the plants. Okay. So, if you talk about the food which we eat, that we call the everyday, you see in the morning, in the breakfast, you see mainly you eat the roti and chapati, yes or no? So, this is one type of carbohydrates. Then you eat the potato, yes or no? This is also a source of a carbohydrates. Okay, so these are the foods which comes under the carbohydrates. Okay, so that is why this gives the instant energy. That is why it is called the energy giving food. Okay. Another is the protein. Protein is also called the bodybuilding food. Why? Because this protein build our body. That means develop our body. Okay. And it even repair worn out cell inside our body and build up the tissues. That means inside our, you can see the our body is made up of various cells and tissues. Yes or no? You can see the skin. What is this? It is one type of cell. It is one type of a tissue. Yes or no? So, somewhere or we can say sometimes we get hurt. You can see it is being repaired after some days. Yes or no? So, that is why this protein is called the bodybuilding food. And even for the children, it is more important because it needs for the growth. Yes or no? If you see the children, how they grow, they need more and more protein. Due to that, their body develops very, very fast. Okay. Another is the fats. It is called the energy bank. Why it is called the energy bank? Because these fats are being stored in the form of a fats, or we can say it gives us heat and energy during the fast, during the when you do the fasting, or we can say during various physical work. Okay, it produces more and more energy during that time. That is why it is called the energy bank. Okay, and once more, if you talk about this protein, if you talk about the source of protein, if you talk about the source of protein, mainly we get from the fish, meat, then you have in plants, we get from the pulses. That means various dal you eat during the day. Yes or no? So, from there you get the protein. And if you talk about the source of fats, that means from where do we get the fats? That is the oil which you eat, then you have the ghee, then you have the butter. Okay, these are the main source of fats. That means from where does we get the fats? Okay, another is the vitamins and minerals. Okay, if you talk about the vitamins and minerals, this we get from the vegetables and the fruits. Vegetables and the fruits. So some are, we can say we get from the raw means we can say in Hindi we call the kacha fruits. Yes or no? Vegetables. Yes or no? So this why it is called the protective food if you talk about, because this build up the immune system, or we can say the fighting skin against the various diseases. Okay, so this develop the fighting skill, or we can say fighting ability towards the various diseases. So the fighting abilities, that is called the immunity, or we can say stamina. Okay, so that is why this vitamins and minerals help us to fight against the various diseases which get inside our body. Okay, that is why it is called the protective food. And these vitamins and minerals we get from the green leafy vegetables, various vegetables we eat, and also the fruits. Okay, so there is some of the important vitamins that we have in our body, or that we get from the vegetables and fruits. That is the vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, and there are some more vitamins, that is vitamin E and K. E and K, and one is the iodine that we get. Okay, and if this all vitamin is not there in our body, what will happen? There is some diseases which is caused by the lack of this vitamins. Okay, for example, vitamin A. Due to the lack of vitamin A, what happens? Or due to the due to the less intake of vitamin A, what happens? Night blindness. If there is, what happens due to vitamin lack of vitamin B? Beriberi, deficiency of beriberi. That means this is the disease which is caused by the lack, or we can say when we take less amount of these all vitamins. Okay. Then lack of vitamin C, scurvy. Lack of vitamin D, rickets. And the iodine, due to iodine what happens, we are affected by the goiter. Okay, so these are the disease which is caused by the lack of these all vitamins. Okay, so and these all what you call, these all disease which you see, which is caused by the lack of, we can say less intake of these all vitamins. So these are non-communicable disease. That means it is not transferred from one person to another. Okay, so this is why it is called the, this vitamins and minerals are called the protective food. Another is the water and roughage. Okay, water and roughage, we already know without water we can't live. Yes or no? Anybody? Yes or no? So this water help us to help us in proper digestion. It helps us in digestion, and it even regulates the temperature of our body. It regulates the temperature of our body. Another function, if you talk about, it transport the various nutrient from one to the all body parts, to the all body parts. Okay. And if you talk about the roughage, it is also called the dietary fibers. It is also called the dietary fibers. And this we get from, this will get from the, like we say, raw fruits, or we can say salad, or we can say radish and carrot, which we see. Why it is called the dietary fibers? Because this type of food contains large amount of fibers. Fibers means a finger-like structure inside the fruits or inside the cover of the fruits. Okay, so that is why it is called the dietary fibers, and it is very important to take these all fibers, or we can say fibrous food, like we say fruits, vegetables. There are various vegetables we used to eat raw, like we say carrot, radish, turnip. Okay, then some of the fruits, then salad. Okay, so what does it do? This actually, it when we eat this kind of fruits or this kind of food, it make us to have the bulkiness. It gives us bulkiness in our stomach so that we can feel that our stomach is full. Yes or no? And due to that, it helps us in proper digestion of our body. Okay, so that is why it is very essential for our body. So the till now, this much you have understood what are the major component, we can say major component of food or nutrient that we, that is necessary for our body. You can see carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals, and water and roughage. And what is balanced diet, that also you learn, what is diet. Okay, so these are the things things which is necessary for our body. Okay, I hope you have understood this topic. In the next topic, talk about the other factors affecting our health, disease and the hygiene. Thank you for listening.